Hey guys, Kincaid here, and welcome back to another video. And in this video, I'm gonna be showing y'all how to get the brand new Vampire Engine on a dusty trip. Let's get right into this. So if y'all don't know, the Vampire Engine is now the new best engine in the game, even better than the VA engine. And to get this, what you have to do is you first have to find the brand new church building. So this is what the church looks like right here. They are kind of rare. Like, I made it to 22,000 meters and I just found the very first one. And then once we get close, we will be ambushed by vampires. So here's this dude right here. Okay, let's just go ahead and run inside. So luckily he isn't hitting us right now, but here is the devil engine. So here is right here. And all right, he is kind of blocking the doorway. All right, let's go ahead and grab it. Let's run out. So we could just run away with his engine right here, but I believe we do get a badge if we kill him. So I really wouldn't do that. But anyway, let's go ahead and slap the devil engine to the side. Let's also go ahead and kill this other dude real quick. So let's grab this and let's go and shoot him. There we go. So I am hitting him with the axe. It's not showing his health, so not too sure about that. Maybe it just doesn't show his health because it is making the sound effect as if I were damaging him, but it's not showing his health. So I'm assuming that the gun probably does work on him. And there we go, we just killed him. Awesome. And then we get this dagger right here, and all right, it has a little red dot with it. And awesome though. So that is how we go ahead and kill him. So it looks like you are able to kill him with anything. It just doesn't show the health above his head, so that's kind of annoying. But we also have this engine now, so I'm not sure if it uses diesel. It might, which it probably does actually. Well, anyway, let's go ahead and hop in here actually, and let's go ahead and remove our current one. So there we go, that should be fine. Let's toss this one in and see if it works. So this is the new best engine though, so I'm assuming that probably does use diesel, but we might as well try it with regular gas. So now let's go ahead and hop in and let's try turning it on, and it did actually start, which is pretty nice. Let's turn the volume up. So it looks like it doesn't use diesel, which is awesome. So this is the best engine. Let's go ahead and grab these guns and then we'll go ahead and test it out. So I guess it actually is really good because it uses gas, which I much rather use gas than diesel because gas is a lot more common. So anyway, let's put this down, let's try it out, let's see how fast we can go. And we're kind of like on a flat slope right now, so we're not even on a hill or downhill or anything. So this is just base speed, and we are already zooming. So it looks like we're going like about 130 right now, pretty good, which I think it did already overheat. So let's turn it back on and let's keep going. So yeah, it did overheat right there. I don't think I have any water in the radiator, so I'll go ahead and do that. But let's finish going downhill though. So far it kind of feels the same as the previous one I was using, but apparently it is the best, and also it definitely looks the coolest. And all right, we're already going like 200 miles per hour. Hopefully we don't crash. Almost hit that rock back there. But also by killing the vampire, we also got one of the brand new weapons. So I believe this is the question mark weapon as well. And oh snap, we almost crashed. And dang, I'm actually super surprised that we didn't hit a single thing right there. Well, I spoke too early. Anyway, let's go ahead and hop out of here. Let's also see if we can find any buildings. I think it probably passed like 10 buildings right there. Well, anyway, it looks like there's a building up there. So let's go ahead and test out this new weapon as well, because it does have like some glowing effects to it, so I'm assuming that's much better than a regular sword. So let's grab it, and now let's just run over to this building, and I'll probably need some dynamite or something to go ahead and flip my van back over. So that does kind of sting, and it looks like we got a double garage right here. Pretty nice. So anyway, let's set that down, let's open these up. Anyone in there? And yes, there is. All right, so let's go ahead and grab this, let's swing at him. So it looks like it's just like a normal weapon, and it looks like I don't have to shake my screen, so it does stab him pretty fast. And there we go, he's already dead. All right, that was actually pretty fast. And now we have this little orb around it. Not really sure what the orb does. I think we had that before and now it's gone. All right, so it is pretty good. All we have to do is kind of hold it there, so we can like stick our arm out and then we can just hold it here. It does quite a bit of damage and it hits them fast. So I think with my other weapons I have to like swing my screen back and forth like this. Not entirely sure, but I'm pretty sure I do. But this, I can just hold it here and it kills them pretty quickly. It would have been nice to have this before I reached the 20,000 meter mark and defeated the ghost town, but yeah, this weapon is actually pretty nice. And I'll probably go ahead and grab that dynamite as well, just so I can go ahead and flip my van back over. And yeah, that was quite a long journey away. Well, anyway, that's how you go ahead and get the vampire engine though on a dusty trip. So that's gonna go ahead and be all for this video. So go ahead and leave a like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. And I'll see you all in the next video.